Hello, my friends. Welcome to another mini message. Today, Saturday, we're going to be talking about Mark 1st from 12 to 13, Satan tempts Jesus.
The Spirit then compelled Jesus to go into the wilderness, where he was tempted by Satan for 40 days. He was out among the wild animals, and angels took care of him.
Yeah. So, the same way that Jesus is an example, right? How to fight that in this world, right? How with faith we can fight the evil, right? Because Satan is going to tempt us, right? And the same way he was surrounded by wild animals, we are surrounded in this world by situations that can be dangerous for us, right? And plus Satan tempting us, you know, tempting our carnal bodies, right? But when we're following our Lord Jesus Christ, like I said, Jesus lives in us. We're representing Jesus, and he was tempted there for 40 days, right? And this little passage doesn't talk much the examples, because we're talking about Mark, maybe later on in Luke or John, we'll talk more. But Jesus was tempted 40 days, right? I mean, he was in the wilderness 40 days without eating, you know, and he was weak and he was tempted by Satan, right? But he's the Word of God. And when we're walking in this world, when the situations around us are dangerous, right? We come with we bring the Word of God with us. We're representing Jesus everywhere we go. So when we're deep in the Word of God, temptation comes, Jesus is going to help us. The Holy Spirit that lives in us is going to help us against the temptations of Satan, right? The dangers of this world. And plus, he's telling us at the end, the angels will help in Jesus, right? The angels help us as well. They serve us. They are there for us to get help, right? When we're in a situation, we pray, and God sends his angels to protect us, to help us grow through situations, right? So this is a life example of how we... that the way Jesus was tempted, we're going to be tempted. But when we're in the Word of God, we're strong.
Well, yeah, I think it's so interesting how verse 12 starts with the Spirit then compelled Jesus to go into the wilderness. Mm-hmm. You would think that that wouldn't be how it would go, but that is exactly what happens. And it is the same way with us. Mm-hmm. It is not God's will that we live on some island away from temptation or from, you know, danger. But oftentimes it is the Holy Spirit that will put us right in front of maybe somebody that we wouldn't normally think to go to, because God's power and might and love of Jesus is going to be shown in that conversation or in that moment. And so when we can realize that Jesus was compelled by the Spirit to go into a place that was unlikely, mm-hmm. away from everyone, in a vulnerable state, and where Satan would try to tempt him there, that same thing, that same scenario is going to happen for us. The Holy Spirit's going to take us places where we may not feel the most comfortable, but it will be the end of ourselves, and all we will have left is for God's power to show up in that moment. Mm-hmm. And we can be victorious. We don't have to fall into sin. We don't have to go for the temptation because we have Jesus living in us. We have the Holy Spirit with us.
Yeah, right. And our faith is going to be, tested, right? Mm-hmm. As a goal, right? We're going to go through fire. Mm-hmm. Our faith is going to go through fire, to situation, because God is testing us in how's our faith, right? Mm-hmm. So we need to be faithful. Yeah? We need to be deep in the Word of God, and God is going to make us go through those situations.
Mm-hmm. Well, maybe I'll just share, to make it more specific. Mm-hmm. I know the Holy Spirit led me to reach out to my father, who had sexually abused me as a child. I would never think to find him and have a conversation with him after almost 20 years of not having him around, you know? Mm-hmm. But the Holy Spirit led me right to him. Mm-hmm. And I was able to, through a series of conversations, which the Holy Spirit guided me through, be able to share the gospel of Jesus Christ with him. And so this is what I know, this scripture so personally, so deeply, that the Spirit will lead us into these wilderness places, these places where we would not go in our right mind, and definitely not alone. But God is with us, yes. Always. And the Holy Spirit will guide us, he will lead us, and he will help us. He gives you the emotions, the power, the words, everything that you need to be able to handle that moment.
Yes, glory to God. God bless you, my friend. Bye.